Stop Olympic lifting unless you are an Olympic lifter and until you watch this entire video. And I'll even share a few things to try. Lee Weiland, Pacific Rim Athletics, creator of Powerbatics. Some of our videos are tongue-in-cheek to stop doing push-ups or squats or whatever. Some of you guys take me so seriously, which you should. But the caveat is always until you try this or that or correct this or that or go beyond them, which is the ultimate outcome. Taking these principles beyond the basics to more advanced levels and hopefully to all of life. But I'm actually pretty serious about this topic. Let me explain, and I'll give several things to start working towards. Olympic lifting is a sport in and of itself. It is highly, highly, highly technical. I worked on these lifts with a very lightweight a long time ago. It didn't take long to realize how sophisticated this training is. And if you love that sport, then awesome, keep going. But the technicality of Olympic lifting is not even up for debate. I'd even say they're on the same level as a round-off backflip. The round-off can generate up to 14 times body weight of force in an instant, meaning for a 150-pound person, that's 2,100 pounds on your Achilles, knees, lower back, and the rest of your system. And the landing is 2 to 3 times body weight as well, to a dead stop. I've only talked to him once, and I didn't think to ask, but I've heard from others that Valeri Lukin, the first to do a triple backflip on floor, practiced round-offs for 2 hours per day. That's how technical I think Olympic lifting is. I'd also put Olympic lifting on the same level as flares, highly technical. I did a guesstimate that it takes about 3,000 repetitions to get flares going continuously, which builds incredible levels of core, leg, and upper body strength, mobility, and power. Thus the name power moves, one of the elements of Powerbatics we do at Pacific Rim Athletics. And I'd also put Olympic lifting on the same level as a double Kong vault from the free run element of Powerbatics, with the whole trip and land on your face if you lack the mobility aspect. Same as a bar coming down and crushing your head or back. Unfortunately, however, Olympic lifting's been juxtaposed, i.e. smashed together with bodyweight training. And that gone and taken mainstream. And that for remedials and beginners. And that gone and done for time. Now, just as a very brief aside, juxtaposing disparate modalities into one system leads to catastrophic entropy of that system unless there's an ever-increasing level of fine-tuning. For example, snatches combined with muscle-ups is going to inevitably lead to the 25 to 75% injury rates that are commonly reported. But back to the technical aspects of Olympic lifting. Even an advanced athlete coming from another sport will have to take 6 months to 1 year to really learn the lifts using PVC, then a barbell, and then slowly adding weights and so on, just like learning a new language or a musical instrument. So beginner trainees all the way to advanced athletes need to recognize that this is an entirely different high-level, highly technical sport demanding high-level, highly technical precision of skill under load. All fine and dandy when you're 16 years old, but we've had consults with many a 26, 36, 46-year-old who tells us that they aren't as fine and dandy anymore. Save for athletic crossover, a collegiate swimmer is a phenomenal athlete, but if they've not learned and incorporated Olympic lifting, then they'll need to take time to learn those lifts. Same for even a power lifter. They'll need to develop all the mobility in all the necessary places in order to even be able to get into the position to do a moderate amount of weight. What's interesting is that if you start Olympic lifting correctly, a good coach will put you on PVC first. And hopefully, they won't even allow you to touch a weight for 6 months to 1 year. Just like a good martial arts instructor teaches you how to strike and then defend over thousands of reps before sticking you in the ring. Now, why that long? Why 6 months or 1 year? Because it takes connective tissue that long to adjust and adapt. If you tear your shoulder, it takes that long to heal after surgery, at least 12 weeks for Sharpie's fibers, and then another 3 months for mobility and strength. As an example, if you're trying to get full middle splits or a back walkover, it's gonna probably take just as long. And a good coach will first properly condition you to be able to do the thing in question. So they should have you developing full ROM squats requiring ankle mobility, knee mobility, hip mobility, lower back and thoracic strength, shoulder mobility, and then all the strength on top of that. Think about this. The snatch position. Let's do a side-by-side with a bodyweight move. The invert hollow back. Same exact thing. See? Open shoulders, hip hinging, etc. Or Lukin's triple back landing in an ATG squat from nearly triple body height. If he's 150 pounds, that's 450 pounds of force on impact, plus whatever rotational forces were accumulated. So when you think about it, a good Olympic lifting coach is also very good at coaching certain elements of bodyweight strength. And that's where a person should start, bodyweight strength. And I'll tell you a few moves you should start with in just a second. But why would a good lifting coach only be good at certain elements of bodyweight strength? Unless, of course, they're already a bodyweight strength expert. Because there are only two different lifts, plus the four accessory lifts, of course, and they're all pretty similar. Make no mistake, I value this enterprise tremendously, so I'm not talking but the however, the on the other hand, the elephant in the room remains. Lateral movement, twisting, inversion, crossbody movement, overstretching and flexibility, dynamic jumps, rebounding, etc., etc., etc. In other words, Olympic lifting is not one-dimensional, but definitely one-directional. In fact, the more perfect the lift, literally the straighter, the more one-directional it is. So what we actually find is a paradox. Olympic lifting, this highly technical athletic pursuit that can yield some tremendous benefit, and as such, this benefit yields one-directional results. In other words, it is a phenomenal athletic enterprise in and of itself, so much so that it's a game changer for athletes in other fields who learn it. The paradox is that it's both a fully-fledged sport that requires so much to learn it, but also because of its one-directionality, a highly sophisticated tool that could be used in the tool belt of other modalities. Geez, it's almost as complex as trying to describe the Trinity or the hypostatic union. And what's interesting is that what actually underpins it is this fractional aspect of bodyweight strength. So why not learn all of bodyweight strength, as we call it powerbatics, first as your foundation. Get the back, shoulder, hip, knee, and Achilles mobility that is necessary for Olympic lifting, plus the lateral movement, twisting, inversion, crossbody movement, overstretching and flexibility, dynamic jumps, rebounding, etc., etc., etc. For omnidirectional strength and skill, such that you have an even greater reserve of strength and mobility than the skill or lift requires. If you really love this modality, then add the two lifts as you would a supercharger onto a car or a new language or another golf club in your golf bag. So beginners, even advanced athletes, that's what I encourage you to do. Stop the Olympic lifts until you get a higher than necessary reservoir of strength and mobility from bodyweight strength. Learn the lifts like you would any other advanced skill, and then add them to your arsenal just as you would a loaded weapon, with care and expert control. And the three moves I think every person should start with, whether they're a beginner or advanced athlete, martial artist, obstacle racer, or lifter, are these. First, the hollow back. Develop your bridge and then keep going for open shoulders and good thoracic mobility and strength. Second, the single leg squat. Develop good mobility in your regular squat first and horse stance, and that from all sorts of angles, knees in, knees out, feet in, feet out, not just straight on like an Olympic lift, but all angles, because that's just real life. And then eventually that turns into single leg squats, even single leggers on toes. Third, the V-stand. This counterposes the hollow back for core strength in the hip hinging position. And then you can progress to things like the round off back flips, snatch, clean and jerk, flares, double Kong vaults, and even Dyna combos and katas, and everything else you want to do. And seriously, I say this in all my videos, but don't mistake videos anywhere for coaching and instruction. I remember watching all these videos for painting, how to model 3D forms, mix color, all that, but absolutely nothing substitutes for having a teacher give you over the shoulder instruction, or having your work put up for an 8-hour long critique. And you can literally talk to me and my team in the next day or two if you really want to accelerate your training and do it safely, and actually more speedily than doing it DIY. There are doctorate physical therapists and expert athletes and coaches, and we'd love to know your goals and help you along. Either way, see you in the next video, or hopefully in training soon.